you know one thing about me, it's that I like swords. There's just something about them. So, as you can probably guess, I was pretty excited for the new King Arthur movie, regardless of what the critics said. But I might be alone in that, since no one seems to have gone to see this film. Seems Warner Brothers are going to lose quite a lot of money, and those 6 planned sequels to create the cinematic universe might have to go on the back burner. Probably for the best, though, really. Of course, this might be the fault of the weird marketing strategies, but who knows. So, is it any good? The answer? Well, yes. Sort of. There's nothing I like more than a good sword and board film. But alas, there was a distinct lack of sword and far too much board. Yes, yes, thank you, thank you. I'd just like to thank my... Honestly, that's a little unfair. I was certainly surprised as to just how little actual sword fighting there was, and how much CGI, magic, flashing lights there was. But let's start with the positives. Charlie Hunnam was great as King Arthur. He was very likable and really funny too. In fact, the acting in general was pretty good, and I did appreciate the Guy Ritchie style, even if it's the thing you might not normally go for when making an Arthurian legend. However, it is used very well in an early montage showing Arthur growing up. As for the special effects, well, they were good, if a little overused. I like the music and the variety of it, but I do think the best thing about the film is Charlie Hunnam. He really put his all into the film. However, the movie does have its problems, quite a few really, and I can understand the negative feedback from both the audiences and the critics. It is definitely a Guy Ritchie film, and his style, as I said, is not the first thing you think of when you imagine King Arthur. Now, while it didn't bother me, I can see some people not really being too keen on it. While the character of Arthur was good, unfortunately none of the other characters really got any real development. The mage was quite cool, but we know almost nothing about her. Which is a shame, as there are basically no decent female characters. Though you could argue that there's only one decent character, that being Arthur. Then there's the pacing, which was a little all over the place, and I get the distinct feeling that a lot of the film ended up on the cutting room floor. But possibly the worst thing was the action. There were parts that were well choreographed, but the camera was always far too close to appreciate what was really happening. And this is what I was saying about the lack of actual sword fighting. Even when the swords are swung, we can barely see it. And while Excalibur was quite cool, it did sort of make him super OP. There was honestly not that much threat. However, all that being said, I actually really enjoyed myself. And perhaps it's a reaction to the low box office scores, but I do think this film deserves more. It has its problems, and feels slightly overproduced as many have said, but if you go in with an open mind, you'll be happily entertained for a couple of hours.